Good morning, Verdugo Dons, and welcome back to the Verdugo Rundown. I'm your host, Cynthia Osain.
And I'm Katie Garmentia.
The Verdugo Rundown is where we talk about school events, activities, and bring you the information that you seek.
This program is brought to you by the Verdugo Hills Leadership for the Verdugo Dons.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
So, in case some of you guys have been living under a rock, I know I have, don't worry. It's been announced that students can now attend school. Yes, this does mean back on campus.
But the only way to get back on campus is by getting tested weekly, wearing a mask, and getting your daily pass. But no worries, we only have a couple weeks of school left, so we can handle this, right?
School's gonna be different this year, but there was no information about how everything was gonna be managed. So we got someone on the inside, Lucas Minton. He will be attending school for the rest of the semester, so he'll be giving us all the details about what's going on. Lucas, it's all yours.
So it's currently lunchtime and I just had food. It was the cafeteria pizza and it was fine. I didn't eat it. There was salad also. They have us wear these blue dots and also lanyards to confirm our identities as hybrid learning people, so that's a thing. Also, there was a fire drill that existed. We went to the football field and stood there for a bit, and then lunch happened. Those are all things that happened today so far. Yeah. Hooray.
Okay, I'm home. Well, I didn't really like hybrid learning, personally, to be completely honest, because I was actively discouraged from participating in class because I was in a room with two other people who could all hear each other, one of whom was teaching the entire time. So I don't really think hybrid learning was the best for me.
So, what was it like to actually be on campus for this?
It wasn't too new or surprising for me, despite the fact that I'm a freshman, because I already was going back to campus for the school musical.
In conclusion, while hybrid learning does have its merits, personally, neither of us here plan on continuing to do it.
It's trivia time! Question, does Mother's Day land on the same day each year? Go ahead, take a guess. The answer was false. Mother's Day was on Sunday, May 9th this year, and it actually changes every year. Fun fact, huh?
A musical that came out in Broadway in 1987 is now coming into your homes, but with a twist. Verdugo Hills held a musical called Into the Woods on Thursday, May 13th through May 15th.
Into the Woods? Never heard of it. What's it about?
Well, we're about to know now. Paulina Renshaw managed to get interviews from the cast on how everyone's feeling and a little summary on the story. Take it away, Paulina.
Hey, Verdugo Dons. I'm Paulina Renshaw, and today I took the time to interview some students that are participating in this year's spring musical, Stephen Sondheim's Into the Woods. This musical is basically about all the fairy tale characters such as Little Red Riding Hood, Jack, Rapunzel, Cinderella, and more, meeting in the woods to finally get their wish, but they learn that sometimes you don't always get what you wish for, and to be careful what you wish for.
Is it my fault I was given those beans? You persuaded me to trade away my cow for beans, and without those beans there'd have been no stalk to get up to the giants in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans were a cow so old that you had to tell a lie to sell it, which you told. Were they worthless beans? Were they over?
I feel very excited. I feel like all of us have worked throughout the entire semester for these next days.
It's so great to finally be doing theater at school. It's so great to see people and interact and actually have like communication that's not through a little box, and it's really, really fantastic.
During the musical, I've been preparing by preparing my voice and preparing my mental health to go and do the show, which I'm very excited for. I've been keeping healthy and I'm just ready for it.
It's different in the sense that we're wearing masks and we have to be a lot more careful with our actions and distancing and everything, but it's still just as fun and you feel just as much support and love and community.
Be super fun, and I hope you all come and see it.
Seniors, we know prom didn't happen this year, and it was a bummer. Things happen, you know? But that didn't stop some of you guys. Students actually sent us videos of them getting ready from home, prom edition. Now that's what I call creativity. They sent us videos of them glamming up, putting on some makeup, mascara, wearing their dress, their tux, fixing their hair. Let me tell you, when I saw them, it looked like they were from Vogue. Vogue, okay? Let me show you.
Hey guys, so I'm gonna be doing a get ready with me for prom, even though we don't have one, but it'll be fun. I'm not an expert in makeup, so don't come for me. I'm gonna be doing concealer, I think that's what it is. So after we do that, we get our sponge. So after we do that, we get this powder. Honestly, the makeup process isn't that long. Like, I'm already at the eyeshadow, but I'm using Morphe. Do this one as the base, this shade of brown. And then like on the corner right here, I like to use like a lighter color. So maybe like one of these sparkles here. Yeah, I'm just gonna curl my hair and then put my eyeliner on because I can't. I need like a magnifying glass to do that. So now I'm just gonna do my mascara. So this is the final look. I'm not wearing a prom dress because I don't have one. I just wore my homecoming dress. But yeah, I hope you guys get ready for no reason and enjoy.
And this is the finishing look. That's how you guys can do an easy prom hairstyle.
Hi everyone, my name is Valentina, and for today's video, I'm gonna be doing a prom get ready with me because it's prom season and it's gonna be more of like a makeup look. So this is the before, and I have my clips in, and I'll show you after when I'm done.
Okay, so this is the after, and when I told you guys it was gonna be like natural, it's really natural. So thank you again for watching my little get ready with me prom edition. This is probably what I would have done for prom, just because it's what I'm most comfortable with, but...
Hey, it's Jaylene! Get prom ready with me! So here's everything in my bag, but you know, I gotta clean my face, pluck them eyebrows, moisturize, sunscreen, you know, everything. Vaseline, because my lips were chapped, blend. And then, you know, I use powder instead of foundation, because I didn't want to wear foundation. And then, I chose eyelashes. I struggled, but it's okay. And then here's me putting on my lip gloss and lipstick. You know? My fourth year, I feel like I've been lacking. Consider me prom ready.
But what's prom without a prom court? The seniors have decided to take on the competition on Instagram. The prom king candidates were Anthony, James, and Alvin, while the prom queen candidates were Daisy, Cynthia, Genesis, and Jaylene. The prom prince candidate was Marilyn, and the prom princess candidate was Lizette. Now let's see who the winners are.
Hey guys, Aline here. Recently we did our prom court elections and we have our winners. Now it's time to see them.
Hi, my name is James Street and I became prom king for Verdugo Hills High School. For those that have voted for me, thank you so much. It truly means a lot and I really appreciate it. I knew that I wouldn't.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Congratulations to our winners, and I do want to say thank you to everyone who participated.
Congratulations to our prom court winners. You deserve it. So make sure you brag about it on social media.
Teacher Appreciation Month. How can we forget about it? Teachers, thank you for everything that you've done over this past year, this whole change. It's honestly amazing how you never stop to amaze the students here at Verdugo. Even if we don't say it enough, we hope you know that we do appreciate everything that you've done. You've went through so many obstacles, talking to black screens, technical difficulties from Zoom, this huge change in general, and especially going back to school and following all these new regulations. You've done so much, and we just want to appreciate you through this video. Again, thank you.
Don't forget to appreciate your teachers. Although students had it tough during virtual learning, just imagine the teachers who were arranging it.
Thank you for watching this month's video of the Verdugo Rundown.
We are grateful for the time you spent to watch this newscast. It's greatly appreciated.
Signing off, I'm Cynthia Osain.
And I'm Katie Garmendia.
Until next time.